back to my YouTube channel Biologically Frolic by Aishwarya. I'm back again with whole new topic animal cell culture. It is one of the modern techniques in biotechnology field. It is the process by which human, animal and insect cells are grown under a favorable artificial environment. Animal cell culture technology in today's world has become indispensable in field of biotechnology. It requires specific technical skills to carry out the animal cell culture successfully. So let's have a look at what is animal cell culturing and what is the importance of animal cell culturing. So animal cell culture technology is the potential technology that involves diverse disciplines. Animal cell culture basically involves in vitro maintenance of animal cells and also propagation of animal cells. Animal cell culture involves isolation of cells from tissue before establishing a culture in a suitable artificial environment. So basically, animal cell culturing is the process by which cells are grown under the controlled conditions, generally outside of their natural environment. Cell culture conditions can vary for each cell type, but artificial environments consist of suitable vessel with substrate or medium that supplies the essential nutrients. Okay, so what basically animal cell culturing involves the condition, the proper maintenance of the proper condition and the media which can provide everything whatever the cell requires. So essential nutrients can be amino acid, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, etc. And it also requires the growth factors, hormones and gases, etc. And it regulates the physicochemical environment that can be pH, buffer, osmotic pressure, temperature. So to grow one type of animal cell, all these things are required. It can be nutrients, a good amount of nutrients are required, a good amount of gases are required, good amount of the growth factor, hormones. So if you provide everything properly, your cells will grow in a very good condition. So that is the thing. And one more thing, important thing is, everything has to be maintained under the proper conditions only. Even though if you do a small mistake in any of the addition, it might be addition of nutrient, it can be addition of hormone, it can be addition of growth factor. Even a small mistake can make a huge change in animal cell culture. It's not easy, it's not, as I told you, it's not so easy to grow an animal cell. If you take plant cell, I'll always compare animal cell with the plant cell so that you can easily understand the differences. So as we see the plant cell, even though if you do little bit variations in the media compositions, nothing much happens. But even if you do a small mistake in the compositions of medias here, it will make a huge difference for your animal cells. So most cells require a surface or an artificial substrate. It can be adherent or monolayer culture, whereas other cells can grow free floating in the culture medium. So some cells will grow in a suspension culture or some will grow in the solid culture. Solid culture, the cells which grows on solid culture, they are usually adherent cells, which the cells which attach to each other. Okay, the one who grows in the suspension culture, they are the one who grows very freely, or they don't attach to each other during the growth. So in practice, the term cell culture refers to the culturing of the cells derived from a multicellular eukaryotes, especially animal cells, in contrast with other types of the cell culture that also grow the cells. So it can be animal cells, it can be insect cells, it can be amphibian cell, fish cell, it can be anything. But animal cell culture involves the growth of all this type of cells. It can be mammalian, it can be the marine animal cells, or it can be human cell, it can be insect cell, it can be anything, any type of animal cell. Okay. So if you just compare animal cell culturing with other cultures, there are so many types of culturings actually. Plant tissue culture, fungal culture, microbial culture and also viral culture. But what makes animal cell culture different from other culture is the moral values what it has. Okay, growing of animal cell is not at all easy. You might have tried using the plant cells. You might have tried using the fungal culture or growing the microbial culture as well. But growing of animal cell culture requires very high maintenance, वेरी हाई अर्थ टिकल कंडीशंस एंड इट इज द मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव मेथड एज आई टोल्ड यू एंड इट रिक्वायर्स एवरीथिंग विद अ सोफिस्टिकेशन. ओके अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इट रिक्वायर्स यू नो द गुड लेबोरेटरी कंडीशंस, गुड टेम्परेचर, गुड एटमोसफियर, एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी अंडर द कंट्रोल. ओनली बाय दैट यू कैन ग्रो एनिमल सेल्स इन द लेबोरेटरीज, अदरवाइज एनिमल सेल कल्चर ग्रोथ इज नॉट एट ऑल ईजी. सो दिस इज अबाउट द एनिमल सेल कल्चरिंग. नेक्स्ट वन, लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ एनिमल सेल कल्चर. द फाउंडेशन ऑफ एनिमल टिश्यू कल्चर हैड टेंड टू ऑकर इन 1880s व्हेन एर्नॉल्ड शोड दैट ल्यूकोसाइट्स कैन डिवाइड आउटसाइड द बॉडी. लेटर इन 1907 रॉस हैरिसन डिस्कवर्ड फ्रॉग टिश्यू कल्चर टेक्निक्स विच लेड टू अ डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन ऑफ एनिमल टिश्यू कल्चर. हेंस हैरिसन इज कंसिडर्ड एज द फादर ऑफ एनिमल सेल कल्चर. ड्यूरिंग 20th सेंचुरी ह्यूमन डिप्लॉयड फाइब्रोब्लास्ट सेल्स दैट इज MRC5 वर एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय हेफलिक एंड मोरेट. इन 1914 लूज एबलिंग कल्चर द फर्स्ट कैंसर सेल्स एंड इन 1951 गे बेस्ड ऑन लूज एंड एबलिंग वर्क demonstrated that tumor cells can also give rise to continuous cell lines. So in today's time we call them as HeLa cell lines. So Ross Harrison, working at Johns Hopkins Medical College and then at Yale University, he published the results of his experiments from 1910 actually, by establishing the methodology of tissue culture. So, cell culture techniques were advanced significantly in 1940s and 1950s to support the research in virology. Then, growing virus cells in cell culture allowed preparation of purified viruses for the manufacture of vaccines. The injectable polio virus, polio vaccine developed by John Salk was one of the first product mass produced using the cell culture techniques. This vaccine was made possible by cell culture research of John Franklin Enders. And one more scientist was also there. His name is Thomas Huckle Weller and Frederick Chapman Robbins. They were awarded a Nobel Prize for their discovery of modern method of growing virus and in monkey and kidney cell. Okay, so this is the historical background of animal cell culturing. So in 1817, Claude Bernard proposed the physiological system of an organism that can be maintained in a living system after the death of an organism. 1897, Loeb demonstrated the survival of cells isolated from blood and connective tissue in serum and plasma. Then in 1907, Harrison cultivated the frog nerve cell in a lymph clot held by the hanging drop method, and he observed the growth of nerve fibers in vitro for several weeks, and he was considered by some as the father of cell culture. Then in 1916, Ross and Jones introduced proteolytic enzyme trypsin for the subculture of adherent cells. In 1940s, the use of antibiotic penicillin and streptomycin in culture medium decreased the problem of contamination in cell culture. So this was the huge discovery actually, the addition of antibiotics in media. In 1952, George Gay established the continuous cell line from a human cervical carcinoma known as HeLa cell lines. The HeLa cell line name has come because of the patient from whom it is taken. So her name was Helen Lane. So that's why the name of the cell line is called as HeLa cell line by her name. Delbecco developed plaque assay for animal viruses using confluent monolayers of cultured cells. So, in upcoming classes, you will also see the medias in which the most famous media is Delbecco's media. Then next, 1955, Eagle studied the nutrient requirement of selected cells in culture and established the first widely used chemically defined media. You, apart from Delbecco's media, Eagle's minimum essential agar media is also the important one. It is again the most famous media in animal cell culture. In 1961, Hayflick and Moret isolated human fibroblast, that is WI38, and showed that they have a finite lifespan in culture. So we'll stop today with this topic. I'll again come up with a new video for this continuous topic. Till then, bye bye.